if there's a chorus of cowbells, then the whole thing's cowbells. If there's a singular whistler, it's this one thing over here.
High-scoring first inning for the College World Series. Vanderbilt gets 7 runs in the first. Both teams end up with 5 total hits. 10 hits combined in game one. The final score, not indicative of how the game played out after the first inning. But Vanderbilt put it on in the bottom of the first. After Mississippi State was able to get a run across, and you thought, okay, here we go.
They're on lighter. He's not going to be invincible tonight.
Yeah.
They made it moot, and Leiter was just fine. But Vandy comes in, has that giant inning, gets that great catch on the foul ball where the right fielder covers a mile to get from his spot and navigates the wall coming head first. A terrific defensive play that really was another spark. Look, they looked like the best team in baseball last night. Sorry, Sarah. And I wouldn't be surprised at all if they take care of business tonight and bring the trophy back. The plaque, do we call it a plaque? It's kind of a plaque-ish trophy.
Yes.
Back to Nashville and our back-to-back World Series, College World Series champions. They certainly looked the part last night. And we talked about the shots of Al Leiter during a Jack Leiter pitched game. It was plenty for me. Whistler, destructive. I don't know how Karl Ravech says, I never noticed it before tonight. And his two booth mates were like, what, are you insane? That's humanly impossible. So
that was
Karl Ravech has incredible broadcasting focus, apparently.
I was watching that live, and I thought, okay, because it was about the seventh or eighth inning, and there was a long pause, and I thought, he's making this up to fill time. Like, there's a gap in time in what's a boring College World Series game.
They're in the chatting part of the game.
And he's just trying to bridge some filler until he gets to break, because they go to break out of it. And I just took it like he just made something up to fill some time and get some chatter going and go to break.
Because the other two guys...
There's no way that was the first time he's ever heard the whistle.
The other two guys were kind of like me talking to Kirby, saying, you are insane if that is the first time that you have heard.
That's the first time he's noticed the whistler.
Really well-played game.
They show shots of the guy in the crowd.
Yeah. They're just good.
Yeah, they are.
They're just good. And... if they can't win it tonight, then you've got Rocker for the decisive game. They're in good shape. They're in very good shape. And the Mississippi State folks last night during that first inning where you're watching them in the crowd, I mean, it just took the air out of the place. Leiter was very complimentary of the Mississippi State fans. But, I don't know that we get the full sense of it on a telecast. But I certainly felt like once they put up that 7 spot, they took any kind of fan fervor out of it. All right, I mean it deflated.
Well, State fans are a lot different without the cowbell. Yeah. You take that away, the artificial noisemakers in Omaha, and they sound like every other fan base. That's what makes them distinctive. And they apparently there are a ton of State fans in Omaha.
Yeah, I'm not surprised. My big group at PaulKowarski.com, my little group, I should say, we're having a conversation about like the whistling versus unified cowbells or unified vuvuzelas or something. And I think there's a fair debate to be had there. Like, if everybody's doing something, it might kind of collectively be annoying, but it also creates like a wall of sound thing where everything's kind of in that sound, right? You get what I'm saying? Like, if there's a chorus of cowbells, then the whole thing's cowbells. If there's a singular whistler, it's this one thing over here. Like, we're working in a remarkable building with sound studios and recording studios. I can never remember what that fancy room with the wooden walls is called. What's that sound system?
Atmos.
You know, and they could make one little sound over there and turn it up. That's like the whistler, one sound over there turned up, as opposed to the whole room surrounding you in cowbell or vuvuzela. Those are two very different experiences, and I think most of us find one preferable to the other.
We hear the whistler like Phil Mickelson hears a clicking sound in his backswing.
You can't hear anything else. Like the vuvuzela constant thing, you kind of get used to. Though I know people at the South African Olympics, South African World Cup were incredibly annoyed by that. But I still think that's kind of like a blanket sound that you could get used to, as opposed to this like one woodpecker.
Karl Ravech, I respect the job you do. That's not the first time you've ever heard the whistler. Thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe and hit the bell so you're notified every time Outkick 360 goes live. We are live weekdays, 11 a.m. Central, noon Eastern, right here across the Outkick network. And while you're at it, like this video and let us know what you think in the comments below.